Greetings, my little subs and subs to be. I am Master Dominic. Angel is currently sleeping because it's super early in the morning. And it's my absolute pleasure to welcome you to the LEGO Skywalker Saga. So, I have always loved the hell out of the LEGO games. And Angel loves the Star Wars games to death. And LEGO Star Wars was actually one of the first LEGO games I tried. So, wanted to try the, newest one of the LEGO Star Wars games, which has all 9 episodes. Of course, I know this isn't a new game, but I'm gonna have fun with it anyway. Okay. So for anybody who doesn't know what the LEGO games are, it's basically just retelling the story of Star Wars. As you can see, I've already started a game and got through about 6% of the game. The LEGO games always just retell the story of whatever game you're playing. Let me into Select 2. But with LEGO stuff, with a lot more comedy. So, we will start off with Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and we'll just do the round through all 9 of them. Okay, I temporarily muted the game audio just for the fact that I heard that that opening Star Wars theme is copyright to hell and back. So, on the off chance, I don't want to get a copyright claim, so yeah, I went ahead and put a block on that. And I will unmute the game just as soon as the opening credits stop. Okay, there we go.
The ambassadors for the Supreme Chancellor request permission to board.
Yes, of course. As you know, a blockade is perfectly legal.
You see what I mean about more comedic? They have Palpatine in the background, and they had a book labeled Evil Plans sitting on the friggin' shelf there. Okay, gotta do all the tutorial stuff to get through this. There we go.
We've been cleared for boarding. Time for us to get these negotiations underway.
Okay, now we gotta get over to the ship to start level one. Naboo Space Trade Federation Battleship. So, obviously, to get all the stuff in a Lego game, you have to explore to hell and back. I'm not going to be doing that initially on stream. So, the plan here is I'm going to play the games and complete each one of the sections, each episode, and most likely I'm going to edit those videos for YouTube. And then after that, I'll do all the free play, you know, explore with whatever character you want stuff. Because imagine something as crazy as having, like, Darth Vader and Princess Leia doing this section of the game. You know, the negotiations for Naboo stuff.
This way, ambassadors.
I gotta make sure to collect as many studs as I can along the way. Oh, actually, hold on. A little mini-map. It doesn't say there is anything here. Yeah, collecting as many studs as I can along the way. Because you need literally billions of studs in order to get all the stuff in this game. The studs are the currency. And you use it to buy upgrades and shit for your characters. There is now a level system in this game. There didn't used to be, now there is. Before it was just play the game and, you know, have fun. Buy your characters using the studs. Now it's like, oh, you can get upgrades and stuff for the characters.
I sense an unusual amount of fear for something as trivial as this trade dispute.
You're gonna collect some loot. Yeah, and this is the training you how to use force power section. Lift. Why am I walking?
That didn't sound trivial.
Dioxus. We need to get out of here.
Hey, don't you dare try to rob me of my money. Me and my damn studs. And now we start fucking up some droids.
So much for the negotiation.
A lightsaber should make short work of that blast door.
Or we could simply fight our way around it. How should we proceed, Master?
Yeah, this part honestly confuses me. Where it's like, cut a hole. There we go.
I'm gonna blast ya.
Ooh, wait, I have an explosive. Hold on. Where's a bunch of droids? There's actually an achievement for killing multiple enemies with an explosive. Did that do it? I had to kill like 3 in one shot. Did I get it? I feel like that should have counted. Oh wait, does it have to be an explosive, like a weapon that you have as a character? Because there are actually some that carry grenades. Oh, damn. I was hoping I could just, like, force push, like, an explosive from the... Ah, damn. Okay, never mind. Still feel like that should have counted, but if that is the reason, I will tentatively accept that. Continuing the story. Suck it, bitch. Oh, and then this part. This is great.
Mr. Jar Jar Binks, Mr. Your humble servant.
Let's get out of here before more.
Oh my God, Jar Jar! You dumb bastard!
Jar Jar, we need to find somewhere safe and warn the Naboo of this invasion.
Excuse me.
I will real quick do. I'll do whatever stuff I know.
Can you take us there?
We'll get me Kyber Bricks, which are the things I need for upgrades. Because I did play this for a bit yesterday, and got through episode 1 at least. 1,200 Kyber Bricks. There are 1,200 little things for me to do in each of the levels to collect, you know, upgrades, so that's gonna take me a while to get.
For my warning, yo, Gungans no like outsiders.
Keep breaking random shit as I go.
Warm welcome.
Oh, don't worry. This hasn't been our day for warm welcome.
Oh, wait, shit, there's one over there. I didn't know about that one. I was actually coming over here to get a blue stud. Branching out. Sweet. The faster I can collect a whole bunch of those Kyber Bricks, the better. Because there's a bunch of stuff that you have to get for, like, bonuses and multipliers that make make getting characters and shit a lot easier. What is that? Because the way you, like, get a lot of stuff in these games is to collect studs and just buy the characters and crap. Okay, I said that I would just play the game and I'm exploring again. That's the thing about these games. There's so much and you get so curious because you're like, wait, what is that? Is that a thing? What about that? That thing? What? Okay. Down to the underwater city. And Obi-Wan gets attacked by fish.
Hey, you, sir. Stop it there.
Hey, okay, Captain Tarbox. Mr. Back.
Not again, Shacha. You, sir, go into the bosses. You, sir, in big doo-doo this time.
How cool.
Is there something you want to tell us, Jar Jar?
It's embarrassing, but, I'm afraid I might have been banished. I've forgotten.
That seems like something it would have been helpful to remember.
As I said, brainless.
Are you going to enlighten us as to why you were banished?
Jar Jar, clumsy oafs. He fashioned the boss's personal Hiba Liba Bongo.
It's a toy. That was an accident.
Yes. Jar Jar accidentally took his hands off the wheel to catch tasty beetles.
Oh, Jesus Christ, Jar Jar. Took his hands off the wheel to catch a bug.
A droid army is about to attack the Naboo.
We shall no like the Naboo.
We must warn them.
We shall give a user Unabongo. The speediest way to the Naboo is going through the planet Kor.
What is to become of Jar Jar Binks here?
Be gone with him!
Alright, we got Jar Jar. He falls under the hero class of characters, which I find hilarious. Like, I know it's technically true, but Jar Jar is just such
Master,
a goober.
Master,
like, to think he counts as a hero is ridiculous. Okay, what is...
I'm more concerned about your track record with submarines.
Rest assured, he will not be driving.
Usually in a Lego game, if something is made out of gold brick like this, it means you need a special weapon to break it. So I guess Jedis aren't able to break gold. Breaking more random shit for money. Alright, gotta have Jar Jar for this part. Okay. Rhythm puzzle. There we go.
Yosa crazy going to planet core? Here's a Yosa Bongo. Whenever Yosa ready to get it crunching.
Lightsaber throw. I didn't break as much stuff as I wanted it to. Alright. And this is the first level where we actually need to be collecting studs and other things in order to make progress on every one of the, I'm gonna say, non-free-roaming levels. There are 6 Kyber bricks up for grabs. 1 for minikits, 1 for challenges.
Don't worry, the Force will guide us.
The Force? Oh, no, no, no!
Quick, shoot!
There he goes. One for mini bricks, 1 for challenges. Kits. 1 for collecting studs.
I'm gonna get
crushed! Damn it. Did I get it? I don't know if I got it or not.
Mesa should have stayed in Otokunga!
Ah, damn it, I didn't get the one earlier. Because it just said that one was 1 out of 5, and I bet the second one I've seen. So I missed one, which means I'm not going to get the Kyber brick.
There's always a bigger fish.
Okay, I can somehow complete 2 of the 3 challenges.
You're losing power.
Stay calm. We're not in trouble yet.
You're nonsense!
Oh yeah, and the six brick is for level completion. So just beating the level will get you 1. Yeah, you beat the level, you get 1. You beat all the challenges, you get 1. You collect all the mini kits, you get 1. And then, you know, depending on how many studs you collect, you can get up to 3.
Full speed ahead.
Unfortunately, some of these levels, it's actually difficult to collect studs because they're, you know, on the rail shooter section like this.
It's toying with us.
Yes, but we should still be able to.
So, I'm thinking that the trick to getting all the Kyber bricks for those is to just, oh shit. Come back after you get a stud multiplier upgrade, so that way every, you know, stud you collect will be worth more, and then it'll count it as a higher total on the list.
I see our friend is hungry again.
Yeah, see, I only got 1.5 the necessary studs to beat that, and I got nearly every single bubble that popped up. Except for like two of them that had mini kits. Unless you get a butt ton of studs for killing the big sea creatures. Like, I always just let them die through story events, but LEGO games are infamous for having multiple routes for completion. So it's entirely possible that I could do more to get studs in that, and I just failed. Free play mode unlocked. So what that means is I can now go back to that and play as any character I want that I've unlocked up to this point. I haven't unlocked many characters though, so... I got 4 out of 5. Yeah, I knew. Okay. Yeah, so it makes me buy that upgrade. Okay. So actually, hold on a sec. Dodge 3 of the Open Sea Killer's attacks in a row. Defeat the Open Sea Killer without being damaged. Dodge 3 of Colo Clawfish's attacks in a row. Okay, so that was the challenges for that one. Yeah, and it doesn't just tell you. You either have to listen to a rumor from another character in the game to learn what you have to do, or you can buy the rumor for 30 grand. Which, fuck that. Yeah, see, so you just need a lot of money for this, which is why I'm holding out for this, the Attract Stud upgrade, which will make it so the studs are just pulled toward me so I can collect them easier. And the stud multipliers. So multipliers stack, so there's a 2, 4, a 6, an 8, and a 10. So all of those together would make it so just one basic stud would be worth hundreds, if not thousands. But I also need these things called data cards, which I don't know how to get those. I will figure that out, though. In the meantime, back to the upgrade menu. Because to get to that one, I have to get this upgrade. And to get this upgrade, I gotta get one each of these. Ah, damn it, I'm short by one brick. Ah, cheap bullshit. Luckily, I know that there's actually one right over here from my minor bit of exploration the previous night. Okay, so let's... So for this one, you just gotta hop on these rocks. Okay. These little cooler thingies float. Got it. Oh, fuck you. Okay, that's not so bad. Smash a couple random things to get back any studs I lost from that. Okay, let's keep going. Forward with the story, smash random shit. Rescue Queen Amidala. Oh wait, what am I doing? I literally just said I need to get that... the brick, so that way I can get an upgrade. Let's see, faster building or counter cash? Press Y when the... okay. Okay, so... damn! Sorry, Qui-Gon! Okay, so if I see an exclamation point, hit Y.
I imagine they'll be taking her to their ship.
If their ship is docked in the hangar, that gives us some time to intercept.
Stop right there.
Yeah, that might not be the best upgrade for me to a bot, because I am very aggressive in these games. I don't counter, I murder.
You're safe now?
I believe so. But who do we have to thank for our rescue?
We're ambassadors to the Supreme Chancellor. It's urgent that we make contact with the Republic. Do you have transports?
In the main hangar. This way.
You're the guy's bombat!
Oh. Oh my god, Jojo is so dumb.
Stay close.
The Queen is not safe here. We must take her to the Republic on Coruscant immediately.
More droids!
Don't let them get away!
Yeah, see, I don't have enough time to hit the counter button. I'm so aggressive that by the time I see the thing pop up, I'm already in an attack combo and just utterly wrecking their shit anyway. Flower stand had a lot of money in them. I'm robbing small businesses here. Boom! Fuck your street lamps. And your flowers. And your flowers. And
your
flowers.
Your Majesty, stay
and your flowers. Oh yeah, you can also grab the enemies and force throw them at each other. It's funny as hell. And fuck you, Jar Jar. But y'all see, I'm barely getting like any studs for this because it's a lot of just silver and gold ones. That's why I need to get, like, the multiplier upgrades and the vacuum upgrades.
Right there. The queen is coming with us.
Make it so I can get more. Alright, we made it to the ship.
This is Her Royal Highness's ship. You
board the ship.
There's the blockade. Shield generator's been hit.
He's beating all the fish. Good job, R2.
There's not enough power to get us to Coruscant. The hyperdrive is leaking.
Here, Master. Tatooine. It's small, out of the way. The Trade Federation has no presence there.
Tatooine, you say? Any suggestion on where we should land?
Mos Espa Spaceport seems like our best option for finding the parts we need.
Mos Espa it is, sir. But land on the outskirts. We don't want to attract attention.
Alright, we're heading to Mos Espa. Tatooine, Mos Espa.
Wait! Her Highness commands that I go with you. She's curious about the planet.
Ursa Arjusa.
I'm Padme, one of the Queen's handmaidens.
This is not a good idea. But if the Queen wishes it... Now we need to find a mechanic selling the parts we need. Let's ask around.
Okay, and there's actually a lot to explore here. So... Okay. Why do I have this? Hold on, that door looks like it needs like some sort of power cell. And that is what this thing looks like. Okay, wait. I think I got it. Okay. I'm gonna have R2 hack this door. Okay, apparently I pissed a bunch of people off. I don't know how. Apparently I'm breaking into their house. Okay, good. Burritos, or whatever the fuck the dude that punch shot his man. Okay, I'm thinking I'm supposed to, like, force possess one of them, but I don't know how to do that. Okay, we're moving on. I could stay in here and murder folks all day, but I have shit to do.
Let me guess, looking for ship parts? Thought so. Everyone is. You'll be wanting to pay Watto a visit. You'll find a shop across town.
Okay, don't know why I turned on some kicking music, but I did.
Hey, Scuba Danaga.
I need parts. Continue the story. Type 327 Nubian. I have 20,000 Republic Dactaries.
Republic carries are no good out here. I need something more real.
You're a funny little boy.
I'm building a pod racer.
You must have Jedi reflexes if you race pods.
There's big race tomorrow on Bundy Eve. You can enter my pod.
Anakin.
The prize credits will more than pay for the parts they need.
The Force is unusually strong with him. That much is clear.
He deserves better than a slave's life.
The boy tells me you want to sponsor him in the race.
Well, I've acquired a pod in a game of chance. I wager my new racing pod against, say, the boy and his mother.
No pod is worth two slaves.
The boy, then.
I love Jar Jar just always getting up to wacky hijinks in the background.
If that's
honestly
everything we need, we should make our way to the arena.
Jar Jar's a dumb character, but him being like such a stooge tends to be hilarious. That is something I want to point out though, like how close I have to be to the studs in order to collect them. Okay, so I need a scavenger class in order to get here, and I don't have one yet. Yeah, different characters have different classes, so you have to use a certain type to get through each puzzle. Yeah, I practically have to be on top of the studs to collect them now, but once I get the vacuum upgrades, it makes it so I can be, like, actually fairly far away and they still get brought to me, which makes collecting them in each level a lot easier. So that, along with the multiplier upgrade, makes it so I just, like, suck up money left and right, no matter what I'm doing. Alright, next non-free-roaming level. And again, it's another level that is super on the rails.
That's absolutely right. And a big turnout here from all corners of the Outer Rim.
And it's the Huts.
Solito Sepulva!
And a lady, the young Anakin Skywalker, a local boy!
Remember, concentrate on the moment. Feel, don't think. Use your instincts.
I will.
May the Force be with you.
Yeah, and this section is basically just hold A to win.
Blasto, Blastomania!
And there goes Skywalker. You'll be hard-pressed to catch up with the leaders today.
And once again, I got some practice last night with this, but holy crap, this section is crazy. Yep, okay. Already not doing well. Okay, great, throw the barrier, oh god. Here. Oop, rocks.
Like
more rock.
Fitting these boss through the notch is like fitting Java into an X-34 land speeder.
So I actually do have to win this race in order to progress. Okay. Oh shit.
Seems like our Rangers have some company.
That bitch! Just sideswiped me. But so long as you basically just keep holding A and just never stop accelerating, you should be fine. And hit as many of those booster pads as you possibly can.
Lap one complete. Just two more to go. If they can survive them. Ouch! Odie Mandrell's race has ended early.
It also tells you where the minikits are on this level. But, oh, fucker!
I'm never gonna win unless I reattach it.
He side swiped me and I friggin' give that power cup. He sideswiped me and I missed the friggin' jump pad.
Not bad for a kid with only two
legs. Asshole. What the hell? I was trying to go straight through that tunnel and just suddenly whipped me to the side.
It doesn't matter how many eyes you got when you head into the darkness of the Laguna Cave.
Murder all of you. Child has the Force, do not piss him off.
Look at him go!
Imagine a child throwing a tantrum with the Force. Jesus fucking Christ, that is horrifying. Oh, minikit. Okay, so I at least get one Kyber Brick for stud collection here, and one minikit. So that gives me a little more studs, I guess. Somehow I completed all the challenges. Oh, shit. There we go. Yeah, I have it set to just automatically do, like, the little, you know, button clicky events. Just so things did not get overly complicated. Because some of these sections are hard enough without having to worry about repeatedly mashing A or B or whatever.
It's Skywalker! The crowd are going nuts!
I'm winning! Victory! Took me about 3 minutes and 20 seconds. Oh god, I got Jar Jar. Again, annoying character, but I love to laugh at him.
Somehow you knew it!
Bring the parts to the main hangar. I'll come by your shop later on so you can release the boy.
Mom! Look at all the credits we have!
Now you can make your dreams come true, Annie.
Pack your things. We haven't much time.
Yippee! Is he to become a Jedi?
Yes.
What about Mom?
Yeah, he's a little Cyclops teddy bear.
It is time for you to let go.
I will come back and free you, Mom. I promise.
Master Anakin, I should prefer it if I were a little more completed.
I'm sorry I wasn't able to finish it, 3PO. Bye.
Oh, my.
Bunta Eve Classic. Level completed. I got one of the three stud collecting bricks. Somehow I got all the level challenges. Again, no idea what I did. Some of them it just seems to happen. Yeah, only got one mini kit. That takes some work to do that one.
Anakin, it's time for us to leave Tatooine. Let's hurry back to the ship.
You mean I get to come with you? In your starship?
If Master Obi-Wan not getting Bordo and leaving us here, he's a no liking Jar Jar.
I don't know about that, Jar Jar.
Okay, and to get that brick protocol droid had, I need a protocol droid. Which means I would have to buy C-3PO. Like the incomplete version we just saw. Which I could do, but I don't want to spend the money. So, like I said, that guy looks a lot like Darth Vader. So, for now, I'm just going to continue on with the story, and if I see bricks that I know I can just get, I will do so. Sockets require plug item to activate. When you find one, use it to locate it. Okay. Oh, it tells me where all this shit is on the map? I didn't know that. Yeah, so I'm gonna have a lot of work to do when I come back.
Anakin, drop barrels!
Yeah, you got fish. So, I'm thinking on what I'll do to play this out is I'll complete episode... No, you know what? I'll get a lot more characters if I just complete each one of the missions, and then I won't have to buy them to complete crap. Because like I said, I have to buy a protocol droid if I want to get that Kyber Brick now. But if I wait a little while, I'll get one from story events for one of the other levels. So I'd rather wait and get the free one over paying for one now, so I can save up my money.
Well, if we can avoid fighting any more hooded strangers, perhaps we'll actually get to Coruscant this time.
Indeed. However, I believe that stranger may have been Sith Lord.
Let's do time warp again. And yes, I know this is light speed travel, not time travel, but that shit looks like the temporal vortex from Doctor Who, so I'm having fun here, okay? And I also know Doctor Who isn't related to that song. Again, I'm just having fun.
A personal welcome from Senator Palpatine himself.
Let us quickly explain the situation Palpatine. In Naboo, so my people may finally be saved.
Greetings, Your Majesty. Master Jedi.
Okay, and before that, let me go to the upgrade menu. I need two more bricks. Fuck you!
It is a great gift to see you alive, Your Majesty. With the communications breakdown, we had begun fearing the worst. I'm anxious to hear about the situation on Naboo. Your Highness, would you be so kind as to accompany me to the Senate to discuss the matter there?
Okay, let me be a Jedi, because
I can move faster. Supreme Chancellor Valoran has called for a special session of the Senate to discuss the situation on Naboo. Though,
we shall end this now, Palpatine.
Yes, little real power, and it is unlikely the Senate will act on the invasion. I believe our best option is for Her Majesty to push for the election of a new Supreme Chancellor.
Yeah, and again, I'm just going to be breaking random shit along the way.
Give us justice.
Like, imagine if this is how this actually went in Star Wars. It was just a scene of them walking down the street and freeing Qui-Gon. He has out his lightsaber. He's breaking random benches and flower pots and other shit along the way. Just because he fucking can.
These transport ships will take us to the Senate building. I have some prior business to attend to, so I shall go on ahead. Once you're ready, come find me in my office. We shall proceed to the meeting. Until then.
Let's see. There's a Kyber brick on that statue's head.
Do you need to get across the planet?
I played this last night and was trying to find lots of different bricks. How did I miss so much? Well, I know how I missed so much. There's 1,200 of the goddamn things in the whole game. I love that the distinction between the characters can be as subtle as this is Qui-Gon Jinn with cape.
Ah, there you are. Are you ready to begin the meeting?
Okay, as far as I know, there's nothing special to collect in here, so let's just go ahead and continue.
We must do something quickly.
He's not even trying to be subtle about hiding.
Order!
This friggin' Darth Maul's standing there with the Jawas, and they're like, hey, who's this guy? Utini? Utini! And then they're just like, okay, yeah, he's a Jawa. He's yelling Utini like a goober.
I've decided to go back to Naboo.
Please, Your Majesty, stay here where it's safe.
And I love how they play up how evil Palpatine is. He's like, oh no, stay here where it's safe. Om nom nom, eating his popcorn as he watches the council dissolve around him.
Clouded, this boy's future is.
Do you really believe we can convince Boss Nass to help us, Your Highness?
What other option is there?
Link.
I have faith we can convince him.
Smash.
I do not know a boss like me, sir. He's a stubborn like a famba.
Encouraging is always
more job. Than landing pad. Yeah, we literally just rode over here for cutscene. Then right back to the place where we just were. Just so we can go somewhere else for more cutscene. Oh my god, there's a brick right here! Give me that shit.
I haven't seen one of these since I was a boy.
Oh, I feel dumb. I feel dumb for not seeing a lot of this. Yeah, and this gives you an idea of how much there is for some of these. 31 in this section and 22 in this section. It's just so damn much. Yeah, unlock all of space by playing through all 9 episodes, then go back to each individual location and explore to find like a few dozen bricks on each planet. Plus get all the ones from story events. God, there's just so damn much. But again, the ones I'm mainly interested in, thank you, are the ones gained from story events. Or no, I'm talking about the upgrades here. I'm dumb. I misspoke. The ones I'm mainly interested in getting. Hey, sweetie, you okay?
Who the hell are you talking to?
That was doing a stream.
Huh.
Hi.
Why didn't you say so?
Because you were sleeping. Because then you sleep.
Where's everybody gone?
The place has been deserted.
Anyway.
The boss mask is still here.
The ones I mainly want to get are the ones that get me more studs. Since you can clearly see, I'm going to be needing a lot of those. There's even an achievement in the game for getting 10 billion studs. And I don't know if that's like over the course of a playthrough or having all of that at once. I'm seriously hoping it's not all at once because that would take me forever to have that much to spare. Whereas having all of that over the course of the game would actually be much easier.
There's nobody here either. Have they been captured?
Perhaps they have. Or maybe they fled.
Of course, sir. Bogenheiden. When in trouble, go to sacred place. Machanix no find them there. Follows me.
All right, we're following Jar Jar. I'm scared for what that means. Okay, it said that they were supposed to be hiding, and yet now there's just random Gungans standing around. Or is the special hiding place only for the Gungan, like, nobles or royalty or whatever the big fat frogman would be?
Found a secret entrance. Misa be needing secret key to get in secret place.
Over the door, Jar Jar.
Around here somewhere. Here we are. But it looks broken. Use a fix and use to enter secret place.
Talk about using your head.
Misa, your boss must be this way.
There we go.
Oh!
Fine, I'm... Can't remember if there was a brick around here or not. I don't see one. I don't think I see anything particularly odd about this place that would suggest one is here. Alright, yeah, let's just continue for now.
I am Queen Amidala.
Oh god, here we go.
No. I am Queen Amidala. I am Queen Amidala.
No! I am Queen Amidala.
Dobra Kwikuni Amidala.
Houdini!
I am Queen Amidala.
I am Queen Amidala.
I'm sorry for my deception, but it was necessary to protect myself. If we do not act quickly, all will be lost forever. I
she
beg you to help us.
Maybe we shall be friends.
Let's head to the palace. We must launch an attack on their control ship and confront the Viceroy.
Oh, no wonder my water was tasting funny. Somehow my little flavor cartridge got turned down to a 1 instead of being on a 2 where it was supposed to be.
With another droid army, Your Highness.
That is why we must head to Theed immediately and retake the palace.
What's my part? I want to help!
You help by hiding somewhere safe and staying alive.
Doesn't sound like help.
Puzzle, come here, girl. Let mommy sleep. Angel was just getting up for a moment to use the bathroom.
Scare the bloody hell out of me, why don't you?
You know, you don't have to get up now, you can keep sleeping.
Yes, because that's gonna happen.
Find cover! Quick!
Get to your ship!
You'll be safe there.
My guess is the Viceroy is in the throne room.
But that's my ship!
Jesus Christ, man, do not throw around a loaded gun.
Why not?
He's just standing there reading this paper, an asshole.
We'll handle this.
We'll take the long way.
Oh yeah, where you were playing this last night, didn't you take like 20 minutes to fight this guy?
Yeah. What Angel's...
More like 45 minutes.
Yeah! What Angel's talking about is I redid this level so I could try to get all the Kyber Bricks. I can't do it unless I have 2 protocol droids. And we've already established just to have 1 at this point, I would have to buy it. So, yeah. I was exploring the living hell out of this level. Taking so long.
Good morning, peoples.
Okay, can I actually fight him now? Jesus.
I don't know, are you done exploring?
Yeah, the boss fight here is surprisingly easy.
He's fleeing.
Which I enjoy.
Which is interesting considering he kills you.
We have company!
Yeah, right? I completely rock him in these actual things, but then cutscene says that I have to die. It's like...
Oh, Well, no. Technically, the movie script George Lucas and everybody worked on the first Star Wars movie, if you ask me that.
Yeah, which is some bullshit.
Yeah, tell George Lucas that to his face, I fucking dare you.
Well, I agree with it narratively for the movie, but here in the game, I barely take any damage from this prick. And yet, cutscene comes along, and he cheap shots me. Okay, you know what, fair enough. Yeah, cocky there and die.
More droids, Master.
Backup has arrived. Roger, Roger.
Why didn't you sound surprised?
What do you mean?
He's like, I have been told food has arrived for me. Like he didn't already know it was coming.
I don't know. Yeah, so for this part, you just have to keep switching back and forth between the two of them, and whoever Darth Maul isn't facing can just jump the guy from behind. Also, how fast would he have to be spinning a lightsaber for it to make, like, air force like that to push him back? Because they are beams of light. They have no actual substance to them.
Well, he also, remember, he's also a very powerful Jedi.
Yeah, so I feel like he's not, like, I feel like spinning the lightsaber is just, like, a show. And he's, like, making the little tornado blast himself with the force.
Come on, we mustn't let him get away.
I'm not sure how he's going to need that.
Yeah, they'll just explain it with the force. Just bring in space wizard magic. That's what the force is. Talking about one of Quinn's favorite movies while he's not in the room. What the heck?
What is
your
favorite movie? Doom?
Doom. We are actually have a playthrough of somebody playing one of the Lego Star Wars games on in the background.
Quite the leap.
Because that is what made us want to play this in the first place.
Find another way to reach it.
Puzzle.
Die anyways, so
puzzle's
like, what the hell difference is
there? Not wrong. Okay. Plug the power conduit back into the lift. And up we go. What's funny is I'm going about as fast as I can with this, because I'm not doing a whole bunch of exploration, I'm just playing the game. And it's about as long as one of the movies for this actually would be. Again, I got cocky there. Didn't back off when I should have. Oh.
Are those Imperial walkers?
Mm-hmm.
These barriers are very dangerous.
Oh my god, he's not even actually using binoculars.
Yeah, he's just doing a little binocular hand joke. Cool, I got one Kyber brick for stud collection.
Perfect. And we shall manually open.
Fix the yellow. Fix the red.
Overcome this obstruction.
Well, yep, yeah, but you thing. Have to...
No, don't put it in the green one. Put the yellow one, dumbass. The red goes in there. We extract the blue to put in here. So it'll open this. And the green go in here. There we go. Qui-Gon, learn how to aim. Use the force, dumbass.
Obi-Wan, raise your lightsaber. A battle resumes.
We're wearing him down, Master.
Yeah, that section right there is basically just to give you money.
Forces with us. We will prevail.
My favorite though last night was your really neat was your Liam Neeson joke. Like, I have a special set of skills. It's like, yeah, you do understand that Liam Neeson was the voice of was the guy who did Qui-Gon Jinn in the first movie, right?
Yeah, if this battle goes on long enough, Qui-Gon Jinn will actually say, I have a special set of skills that will come in handy. And I was like, okay there, Liam Neeson. And then Angel told me that Liam Neeson was actually the same person who played Qui-Gon Jinn as what played the father in Taken.
Yeah, he played in Fairy of Flight. They did that joke. Good God.
Your little insurrection is at an end, Your Highness.
Well,
personally, your occupation here has ended.
After her, this one's a decoy.
And then the running joke that they believe the old man with the Gandalf beard is supposed to be Amidala.
We gotta do something, Archie.
Yeah, so they just use a old man as her decoy instead of, you know, being somebody that actually looks like her just for shits and giggles. This is why I love the Lego games. They do stupid shit like that, and it's so funny.
Why couldn't he get his own shit?
Okay, there was their Jaws joke.
Yeah.
We shall ready to do us a part.
Except he didn't leave the boat.
I mean, he still has the fishermen there.
Yeah. We're some warriors. We're some of the Grand Army.
General Jaja, we some must be making our way to the battlefield.
Well, yeah, well, isn't that the same joke they pulled at the end of the fourth one in Quinn's playthrough? They were taking off and some guy gets caught on the side of the ship.
Oh, yeah. There's stupid jokes throughout all of the different levels. It's just going to be non-stop ridiculousness, I swear.
And it's so funny because half of these people are not as dumb as they are portrayed.
Well, yeah, that's the point of the Lego games. They're just supposed to be stupid and comedic through and through. They do not take themselves seriously at all. And that's why they're amazing. I love how Jar Jar just walks around, by the way. He's like... He's not walking, he's flailing.
Okay! Let me rephrase that.
All of you, sir.
The only person in number...
Weezer, go in as quick as Weezer can.
In episode Weezer one who's not an idiot, missing. Or who is an idiot, rather, is Jar Jar.
Sir, help us find them. Jar Jar. Weezer must help them to load the wagon.
I mean, you kind of got to love him sometimes.
Yeah, he's an annoying character, but he's funny.
Yeah, he is funny.
That is what I've been saying this whole time. Jar Jar is stupid, but that's why he's enjoyable.
He doesn't take himself seriously. He's comic relief.
Big Lug would never move.
I mean, for anybody who wasn't paying attention, they lost a lot of their, like, explosives. So you gotta recollect them. And for some reason, they're leaving that up to fucking Jar Jar. Let Jar Jar handle the explosives. That's smart. Well, at this point, they're like, okay, he's friends with the Jedi. He's been helping him the whole time. He's redeemed himself for being such a clumsy fuck-up. Let's make him a general. Because they've been calling him General Jar Jar.
Well, he does get a title.
Cutting up the shield.
Because, again, he helps them make friends with the Naboo.
Yeah.
What the fuck was that?
A guy mowing the lawn out here, right when the army shows up, and he's like, "Yep, no, fuck this. I'm gonna go work
so
over
what
here."
What is this green stuff that he keeps spitting out?
You're so scary.
Grass.
Well, yeah, but it doesn't look like the grass is getting any shorter.
It was in the places where he was actually mowing, if you really look. Isn't that how it always is? You go to mow the grass, and it's right when, you know...
In the middle of a war. Yeah, that's... because that happens so often.
I wasn't gonna say that. I was gonna say, like, it starts raining or something.
Yeah... Puzzle, will you leave my bagel alone?
I want a bagel. They're yummy.
Ladies! And... Attack them, sir! Armor! Inside of the shields! We shall must attack!
And now Jar Jar has a laser staff!
Oh yeah, so that's an even better idea!
Yes, Jar Jar is now armed! It's Jar Jar, so Jar Jar levels of damage. Which we've established can be quite harrowing. There might be a trick to this to get rid of those vines. Oop. That was not a droid. Puzzle's running around being a little zoom key.
Catapults are broken!
What if we squish it together and make a big catapult?
Oh, oops. I did that early. Okay, I get it. You were supposed to wait a moment. Okay, and then you could do it.
That's a one come. Where's your catapult?
It's a homing song.
Alright, and then for this section, we just start dropping bombs on the battlefield. And so it just gives me like a set number of things I have to blow the shit out of.
Nearly boss arrived.
My hair is about half an inch too short.
We'll get used to it.
Is that mechanics?
Yeah, like I said, give me about a month and a half.
This a hits it!
Of course you do, Han. Because... why the fuck not?
Come on, blow it up. Yeah.
Sorry. This will do better.
Okay, now just start drifting through here, blowing up droids.
Uh-oh.
Shield down. Bumblebee's in deep trouble now.
We shall have to fight. Never beckons down.
I wish I could have thrown the bombs all the way to the back row where the deployment ships were and just blow them up.
General Jaja, be something of something.
I give up. I give up.
Even the giant lizard thing they were riding on are in the background with their hands up. Bye, bitch.
There they are.
R2's like, okay, my human said turn off the autopilot, so you get to leave. Bye!
Little autopilot's back there. No! You can't get rid of me!
He's just drifting through space being all pissed now.
Come on, R2. Let's see what this ship can do.
All right, start the next level.
This is death! Go back.
Now we get to shoot things as a small pilot.
So that's what I'm gonna
small
do.
Pilot.
Bravo flight, let's get in close.
Wait, can you rewind that? What the fuck was that?
Looked like asteroids.
Trouble, just hang on.
If the Gungans are going to win the ground assault, we need to
okay, that's okay, that does not pause when I pause.
Let's
okay, okay. Yeah. Oh god. This section's trippy because it's zero gravity bullshit.
We need to take them out.
We can take out those turrets, can't we, R2?
I love it. You've actually sitting there playing asteroids because Chewie set the wrong coordinates.
You hear that, R2? They need help.
That is hilarious. Okay.
I'm sorry. That is just like one of the funniest things I think I've ever seen.
There are so many ships. We gotta shoot some more.
No, clearly you can't go back. Why would you be able to go back? I mean, that just would make sense.
We have
that
to cut the Trade Federation's connection with their ground forces. Destroy the signal antenna.
I am trying to destroy all the shit. Give me a moment.
It's working, R2. It's working.
All fighters, target those turrets. They're causing us some serious damage.
Up in this.
What a shot!
We don't have all day!
We aren't gonna stop this thing from the outside. We gotta get in to do real damage.
Alright, now the. Okay. Alright, now the part where I fly my ship straight into their ship and start just fucking stuff up royal.
Why?
Because apparently they didn't expect somebody just to just fly into their hangar and just start shooting. Which I honestly find hilarious.
Those fighters that make it inside the battle station target any and all power cores. I repeat, target any and all power cores.
Like, obviously, if you leave a fucking door open, somebody's just gonna fly in and start breaking shit.
Yeah, because that's actually not what happened.
Oops, this is not good.
Breaking all the things.
Whoa! There are so many droids! Hey, you're right! We should shoot those power cores! Now this is pod racing!
Look, one of ours out of the main hold!
Control ship has been destroyed! Look!
We win! Fuck y'all!
They are broken! Are you fucking shitting me?
I love the attention to detail that when he ran over the bots, it started spitting out like white and silver studs instead of green.
Jesus Christ!
And then they tout them through the streets.
Congratulations on your election, Chancellor.
Together, we shall bring peace and prosperity to the Republic.
What will happen to me now?
Like, seriously, they are carrying the dead bodies of their fallen foes through the streets like trophies.
Always do.
The Gungans are fucking terrifying.
Okay.
And they are now just riding around on the explosive pods for fun.
Why not?
Okay, I actually got the three Kyber bricks for that one. We're collecting studs, so that is awesome. And I apparently got the one for challenges. Nice. The only one I'm missing is for mini kits. Because I think I only got, like, how many of those did I get? One, two, three? I got three? I don't even know where I got those three. I was just shooting things, like, so fucking randomly. Alright, episode 1 done, and I apparently got a 50% rating. Select this mode to explore areas you've discovered in free play without an active event. Play as characters you've unlocked to get Kyber bricks, ships, and more. Complete episodes to unlock more of the galaxy.